Okay, we are officially on Friday, second day of Warbirds and Classics over Michigan. Let's get them in the air. And this is Chuck Hamilton's Hangar 9 Oscar that he has stripped down, fiberglassed, scale detail, the whole nine yards. I believe it has a Sato 93 cylinder in it. So the whole purpose of Chuck doing this project was to show how you can personalize, you know, a lot of these ARFs that are on the market to kind of make it your own. A beautiful looking airplane. down lower, though, and get these mosquitoes out of here. This is a very unique combination of B-25s. We got two Zerolis that are electric powered. We got an ESM that is powered by two YS Glow four strokes and an American Eagle, which I believe has two 55s or 50s in it, gas that is. So very interesting formation here. Probably won't be much formation because of the high wind. Just having them all up at the same time is pretty cool. Excuse me. Frankie's flying high cover. Somebody's got to do it, right? Keeping them together kind of nice. It's kind of a neat looking formation, like a vertical diamond type situation. Well, it was. hard time focusing today. That sucker right to the ground. Nice, Frankie. Funny, last year me and RJ rode up to Minnesota for the Warbird event up in Owatonna, and we were talking about his P-47 Big John, and sure enough on the radio comes the song Big John. It's kind of funny. Notice on days like today, you're not going to see too many long scale takeoff rolls. It's with a kind of a cornering crosswind. Give it the power that you got and just get it in the air. RJ's experiencing a minor engine fire. Should get it extinguished. There it goes. It's windy when the crosswind picks up and carves P-47. Brian, that thing's not sounding too healthy. Crosswind, Al never bounces.
Modified. control, heavily modified. And a lot of preparation to go into these airplanes. You don't just come out and go. There's a lot done behind the scenes. I think for every minute you fly, it's 75.
That's a long walk. Nice.
No flare.
Oh, easy. Wow.
Yeah, it is, pretty much.
Not bad. He held on to it good. Good job, Wolf.
G26 two-stroke gas engine. Just enough at 80% throttle to keep this airplane in the air. Carl's choosy about where he likes to fly this. We have 11 acres here at the Capital Area Radio Drone Quadrant. So he's got plenty of room to fly this magnificent, one-of-a-kind airplane. Carl's approach is to find an airplane that catches his fancy. Center of gravity, the range of motion for the control quadrants, the elevator, the aileron. You can imagine initial flights with these are a nerve-wracking event, but Carl's been doing this a long time. This particular aircraft has been through 11 seasons. Don't be quiet unless you enjoy the show. And it's an absolutely fantastic Corsair there. Gear down, spotter, and the red cap. Right, full flaps, gear down and locked. Looking for the center of the runway. These are line-of-sight aircraft today. No drone, no navigation. Flying these by the, I hate to say few, a lot of experience.
It's absolutely amazing how slow this airplane flies.
On the other hand, the bomb drop right now with spread bombs all over Eaton County.
Carl's cutting this flight a little short because it's pretty windy.
But there's plenty of participants willing to go pick them up.
Gears down, all engines are running. Wind down the runway.
Thanks, Daddy. Start. Check in.
And the wind has died down.
Propellers turning in the back. Very nice flight. By Carl Bockhuber from Mayville, Wisconsin. Comes a long way today. We're part of the Warbirds